Yo, what up, man? What up, what up? It's your boy Chuck, Entrepreneur TV. Make sure y'all fucking jump off the bed, off the couch, and boom on that subscribe button for me, man. I need all the followers and subscribers I can get to make this Entrepreneur TV thing grow. Appreciate y'all. Just wanted to drop in, give y'all a little quick message before I get on about my day. This is for service providers, such as myself, landscapers, junk removers. You'll hear me refer to that a lot because that's what I personally do. But this is also for, you know, anybody who pulls up somewhere on a client to do something, mobile mechanics, mobile detailers, painters, carpenters, you know, shit like that. You provide a service and you take it to the customer. They don't come to you. You go to them for the service. They pay you whatever you charge. So we're gonna get right into it. So a lot of times, like in my field, we pull up and we deliver quotes. We tell the customer what we're gonna do, how much it's gonna cost. You know, others, you might have a price, you might understand what needs to be done without having to come take a look at it. You pull up, you do what you say you're gonna do. But that's the important part. That's number one. You know, make sure you do exactly what you tell the customer you're gonna do. So if I say I'm gonna cut the grass, I'm gonna edge it, I'm gonna shape your bushes, it's all gonna look nice and neat, it's gonna be clean, and that's what they're gonna expect from me. You know what I'm saying? So if I don't deliver that, then it's on that customer if they don't want to use my services no more. And a lot of us get thrown away because we give all these lofty expectations, we telling the customer what we're gonna do, and it just doesn't look like that at the end of the job. So we got to be real careful about how we explain our services to the customer. You know, we want to be completely honest about what we can and what we cannot do, because sometimes with the customer might be asking for 3 or 4 different things within that one service. Maybe you can only do 2 or 3 of them things, but if that customer knows that ahead of time, they have the decision to purchase those 2 or 3 things from you and go somewhere else for the 4th, or they could just be like, you know, this ain't gonna work, you know, let me go about my way. But at least you don't lose a potential client in the future, or you don't put a bad word on the street and your word travels. You know, as service providers, you know, again, you know, landscapers, junk removals, mobile mechanics, painters, things like that, we're not doing it across the whole damn world. You know, we in a geographical area, you know, maybe your hood, maybe surrounding areas. So when they go to spit in that word, your word bad, it's gonna travel quick. It's gonna travel quick. You ain't gonna be getting business for a minute. You know, it could hurt you. It really can. Another thing that's very, very important, it's almost as important as providing what you say you're gonna provide, but timing, punctuation. If you tell a person you're gonna be there at 8, get there at 8. You know, a couple minutes before, a couple minutes after, but 8. You know what I'm saying? Like, stop calling people, telling them, oh, man, this happened, that happened, I ain't gonna be there till 9, 10 o'clock. People don't care about that shit. Little JoJo having his birthday party in the morning and they need the grass cut. They selling a house, they need a room painted. They doing this, they doing that. You know what I'm saying? Some people are doing routine things, but within that routine, they have their own reasonings for why it needs to be done at this time, this day, or within this time frame. So you got to make that happen. You know what I mean? That's part of you being honest, you know, because I see a lot of dudes, especially young entrepreneurs, they tell a person a time, or they tell a person XYZ just so they can land that job, like telling somebody what they want to hear just to get the job, just to get the bag. And that's, you know, that's cool or whatever. It's going to work sometimes. But again, it's going to go back to your word. The word going to spread. I mean, you know, Chuck, he do all right work, but he always late. You know, just that authorities. People love punctuation because that makes you dependable. Your word makes you dependable. Your word makes you trustworthy. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of my clients, I'm allowed to come do work at their homes when they're not even home. People have left me keys, all types of shit, because I'm trustworthy. Because when I say it, I mean it. I'm going to do it. And that's important, man. I can't stress that enough about being on time and about delivering what you say you want to deliver. And I like to under-promise and over-deliver. And I'm purposely under-promising. I'm telling you, yeah, I might be able to hit that big shrub. I might, you know what I'm saying? And then I'm going to slice that bitch. I knew I was going to slice it, but it's the wow factor. Create that wow factor, you know, but we'll get into that later. That's a little overhead for some, you know. But again, you want to be able to deliver what you're telling people you're going to deliver. Highly important. Highly important. If you're telling them your service is going to be a Lamborghini, then your service better be a Lamborghini, man. It got to be looking like it. Or don't tell them. And the time and day you say you're going to deliver that service is the time and the day it needs to happen. Now, shit does happen. So if you know you're not going to be able to make that at 8 o'clock a day, 2 days before, let that customer know, because they're going to appreciate that you gave them the opportunity to move some things around, or they know when to expect you. You know what I'm saying? Because I learned this lesson the hard way. I actually lost a client like that. She loved my work too. You know, she loved my work. I mean, absolutely love it. And the people I was sending, you know, when I couldn't go, she loved their work. We do good work. But when I was sending people, you know, when I wasn't coming myself and I was sending my crews, I was forgetting to tell her the time and the day we was coming. And another thing I'm going to get into is, I'm getting right to it. So she's looking out her window, or she's coming outside with her dog, and this stranger's walking around in her yard, and she's a single mom, you know, single woman. So that, I mean, I put my guys in danger, you know what I mean? Because she could have pulled the blick, and that's what she was saying. She like, I live in Atlanta, you know, like South Atlanta. So you know, Atlanta, like, it's a little sketch over there. And to come outside, and it's just random men, grown men, walking around in the yard, checking it out. I mean, it's not a good look on my behalf, you know, for not letting her know the time and the day it was coming. And secondly, make sure, you know, if you got crews, even if they don't work for you, if you're sending them to do work for you, make sure they got, like, one of your shirts, or, like, they wearing a safety vest or something, or they looking like they working. Like, one thing we got to do, guys, man, and this shit boils my blood, yo. We got to stop pulling up to people's houses and doing work just in some random-ass Cancun t-shirts or goddamn wife beaters and dirty sweats or whatever your throwaways is in your closet. Stop pulling up to people's houses and working in that shit, man. You know what I'm saying? Because that was one thing that possibly could have saved my client. If she looked out her window and came outside and she seen some Chuck Dash shirts, she seen some professional looking shit, like, oh, you know, well, he didn't tell me he was coming, but they out here. No, she having to put two and two together, like, who is this in my yard? They walking around the back. She running to the front. Oh, a truck and a trailer. It must be Chuck guys. She calling me, like, you know, XYZ. She mad, cussing and shit, and she ain't called me back. She ain't called me back. I have been doing her yard a year straight. Lost a customer. Pays on time. You be out there working, and your cash up go off. You ain't even did the work yet, and she paid. And I'm the class. A ninja won't stick, yeah. So I dropped that bag. That's my fault. So that's why I'm telling you. So you don't drop the bag like I did. So remember, service providers that pull up on people. You know, landscapers, junk removal. We went through it. Painters, carpenters, mobile mechanics, mobile detailers. I mean, the list goes on. If you go to somebody's house to provide the service, be on time, punctual, you know. And whatever you told them, whatever the quote is, whether you came out and did the quote or you told them over the phone, make that the quote. You know, that's another thing going into making sure you do what you say you're going to do. Don't get there. Start doing it. And all of a sudden, oh, it's, you need, Now, that could be different for, like, contractors who are doing, like, work on your home, you know, remodeling and shit like that, because once you start ripping into them walls and, you know, removing tubs, doing this, then the third, other things come up, you know, other things do come up. But even then, you know, you could be like, listen, this is what the base quote is, but if I get in there and it's XYZ, I'm going to show you what it is, and I'm going to show you what it costs, and we can keep it moving. You know, but other than that, don't get there and say, oh, man, the flower bed, da-da-da-da, I can't do it for the 200, it got to be 300. No, people don't like that shit. Make sure when you go do the quote, if you got to damn near do the work to make sure you provide a good quote, then that's what you do, man. All right? So doing what you say you're going to do, being on time, on time, day and time, and look the part. Look the part. Stop wearing your fucking dusty, busty ass LA Fitness shirts to work in somebody's yard, man. I don't want you in my yard looking like you fucking found a lawnmower, man, and decided to cut grass today, yo. That's just stupid, man. It's your boy Chuck, Entrepreneur TV, checking out. See y'all later, man. I'm finna go to work.